Welcome to Los Scandalous Shake and Bake Arena, home of the Los Scandalous Vault and Dam.
Wait, what? Both teams share the same arena?
Yeah, except when they're playing each other, and then I don't know who the home team is, really.
Now I'm confused, Grim.
Today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams take the field. The Mile High Chronic take on the Los Scandalous Vaults. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's MFL game day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down greased street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. And it's first and 10. First and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and 5. And then Cats will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good.
All you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, pal?
And it's first and 10. And this guy looks like Thor on fumble. You gotta protect the ball better than that. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. The 20. He's at the 10. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd.
Yeah.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10. The ball into the defense, picking up 7. Second and 3. First down. And the running game opens up for them and allows the passing game to be more of a threat. Gotta keep them guessing. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. And then to first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6.
Hot one, hot two.
And that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Third down and long. And that's the way you do it. Eat up chunks of yards with pinpoint passing. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's bleak, Bricks. It's good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. First and 10. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. Like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half?
The kick is good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And it's first and 10. Quarter one comes to an end. If they don't get it together, this game is going to turn into a rout. Second and 3. And he'll pick up the first down with a nice piece of running there. And it's first and 10. Looks like a pass, and it's bouncing right back to the QB. Oh, it's the sticky ball dirty trick.
face, then his crotch. I want to see if he cries or pisses himself first.
Second down in a very lot. And a nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in our hearts.
Third down and 8. Great play by the defense results in an interception. Oh, with a brutal hit.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
And it's first and 10. Threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. That'll bring up second and 1. He got rid of it out of bounds. That's better than throwing a pick, I suppose. And that'll bring up third and 1. Great catch, and that puts 6 points on the board.
The defense could do anything to stop a throw that good, Ben.
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuff burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. Not much there, maybe a yard. Second down and 9. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Third down and 9. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the changes, Gordon, did it? How good can it be?
Man, this coach must have played too many video games. You gotta punt it here. Come on. I'm surprised no one uses the
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Thank you. And it's first and 10. The ball man about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. My parole officer calls. I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And so, that's the 2-minute warning. First down and 9. Offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
Second down and more than the QB would like.
Hot one, hot two.
I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Third down and 9. The defense is trying to keep some time on the clock for their offense, or someone let a real bonehead touch the controller. They get ready for the kick. This isn't a gimme. And it's good!
You know, Grim, in this league, we're murdered.
Hey, Bricks, check the rule book. Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Chance for a good return here. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10. Of water with strawberry fields. Oh man, what a throw! That pass was way off target, but I'm pretty sure the QB will blame the receiver as he always does. Second down and 10. Oh, he's going berserk. The ball carrier better watch out, because if he gets hit, he is dead. Third down and, well, good luck. Defense gives up 5 yards there. At this point, they're going to have to get the ball back by any means necessary, or wasting 2 timeouts on the defense is really going to bite them in the ass. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. And he snags the punt and oh, nice hit. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they could start cheating and killing. That's what I'd do.
Oh, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Oh, mama! He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. Pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and 3. And he held on to that one for a first down. First down and 5.
Much like my wedding night, there was a big explosion, but then everyone left disappointed.
Everyone? You had more than 2 people in the room?
Yeah, the guy filming and the clown. Somebody's got to make the balloon animals.
Third down and 6. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Glenn.
It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. And that's a pass that went nowhere.
That's like me at the hotel bar every night.
Hey, maybe you need a better opening line than you want to see the teeth grown out of the roof of my mouth.
What? The book How to Pick Up Girls and Tell Them Something Unique About Yourself. That's unique.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. Second down and a lot. Zings it in there for a 4-yard gain. Third down and the punter is warming up. 7 yards on the catch, nicely done. Comes the most underrated position in football. They're going for a fake punt. That's riskier than sticking your hand in a blender, and they get stomped cold.
Hey, Grim, Remember what I said when Bricks wanted to bring in a fish buffet in our tiny air seal broadcast booth?
I believe that was, who could have thought that was a good idea?
Yeah, just checking. I'm thinking that again.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Second down and long. And then to first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Dirty trick, and he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had so long today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And it's first and 10. And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't wrong in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. And he picks up 2 yards on the catch. Second and 8 to go.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Hey, okay, man, Kim on, yeah, I got, get on up, get up.
Third down and, well, good luck.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. Nice punt. Should move them back nice. Nice catch. And he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a... Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made it to... Grim, it'll be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. First and 10. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. That's the end of the third quarter. And look, folks, I'll be honest, I don't see a chance in hell in here. First. first and four. And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Goes into the hurry up formation to try to conserve time.
Whoa.
The defense puts one over on the quarterback with a sticky ball dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life
or die.
Second down and a lot. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
It ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
Third down and long.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and ten. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money.
And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, man. Like a haiku.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and ten. Second down in a very lot. They've used a strawberry field dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is now. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. And it's first and ten. When defensive players go berserk, they've been known to rip the heads off of enemy players. Second down and more than the QB would like. Run It's first and ten.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and long. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Third down and the punter is warming up. That ball was almost intercepted. For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sits up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Oh, he just got crushed. And it's first and ten. And chainsaws really have a way of extending the red zone on account of all that blood. Quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up? It's a zap attack. It's like when you shuffle your...
And then he jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble. That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. And it's first and ten. Crusher right there, folks. The defense calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Second down and five. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be up.
The defense calls a second timeout. They really need to make a stop here. And it's first and ten. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
No more timeouts for the defense!
Or the offense, Bricks. That's the important part. Second down and ten. And that's how you run it, folks. Picks up eight there. Third and two. And that's how you run the football. First down. And it's first and ten. To dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in. You know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. Fermented anything really tastes good.
And the Los Scandalous Vols take the win today. Folks, this wasn't even close. It was a total shellacking, like watching a knife cut through butter.
More like an axe through butter, Grim.
Or like a chainsaw through baby shit, because that pretty much describes what we just saw.
And the MVP of today's game is just about to speak. As soon as he gets his jaw back in place. Nope, there he's got it now. Yep.
Hey, man.
and thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Microhard Corporation. They get it right every up.